Hello friends, welcome you all to another video, and today we are going to continue paper number 4 and unit number 3, and we have started the B part of unit number 3 yesterday, and we started with a poem which was written by John Donne, and the title of that poem is A Valediction for Wedding Morning. And yesterday actually I have read entire poem, and also I have explain the first 6 lines of this poem, which you can see on your screen. So that was the "as virtuous men pass mildly away and whisper to their souls to go, whilst some of their sad friends do say, the breath goes now and say no, so let us melt and make no noise, no fear floods nor sigh tempest move." So yesterday I have explained you that the poet has to go away from his beloved, and his beloved is actually she was very sad, she was very unhappy, and she was shedding her tears, and therefore poet is actually convincing her that they should depart and they should not make any kind of noise, and there should be not any kind of a tear floods in her eyes. So up to it I think we have seen in the yesterday's lecture, and today we are going to continue our lecture. So now I'm going to read out the further lines, and then one by one I'm going to explain it. "It were profanation of our choice to tell the light our love." Okay, so actually it should be a very very joyful that even though they are separating, but their love is there, their love is a profound, and therefore they should enjoy that love. Okay, because their love is the lighty, and so therefore they should enjoy that even though they are separating, they are living far, or there is a great distance between them, but even though they love each other, and that is also good enjoy. विरहा मध्ये पण एक प्रकारचं आनंद असतो, आणि तो आनंद इथे आपण घेतला पाहिजे असं कवी आपल्या प्रेयसीला सांगत आहे. "Moving of the earth brings harms and fears. Moving of the earth brings harms and fear. Men reckon what it did and meant. But trepidation of the spares, though greater far, is innocence." And now again the poet is actually giving the examples of that how the moving of the earth. Okay, so moving of the earth is actually brings some kind of harms and fears, because you know that because of the movement of the earth we can see day and night. Okay, day and night. "Men reckon what it I meant." Okay, so the men reckon that because the earth moves, and therefore day and night comes, and that's where the harmness and some fears also come. And men reckon that they have, if they move away from their beloved, it may be have some harms, and therefore women have a fear that if the man has changed. Okay, there is a beautiful song also in Hindi, "Mausam ki tarah tum badal to na jaoge." Okay, like that. So actually here the poet is actually talking that even though he is separating, he is moving from her, but earth also moves around the sun, so likewise he will move around her only. He will not separate completely from her. He will attach her, and therefore, even though, but trepidation of spares, though greater far, is innocent. Actually, the earth moves around the sun. Even though there is a great distance between sun and earth and other planets, but they moves around the sun because sun is on the center. So likewise, he said that even though he move around in the sphere around her, and even though it may be the very far, but it is innocent, and therefore there will be no harm, there will be no fears, and therefore he will not lose her, he will not deceive her, he will love her, and definitely he will come back again. There is no issue, even though he is going far from her, even though they are separating now, but as earth moves around sun and it has not separated completely from the sun, likewise he is not going to separate from her, he is not going to go very far from her. Even though he is far, now he is going away, but very soon he will come back. So that is the thing that he tried to make it clear to his beloved, that she should not worry, she should not think in that way. And so he was convincing her. Let's move to the next stanza. Dull sublunary lover's love, whose soul is sense, cannot admit of sense, because it doth remove those things which limited it. So dull sublunary lover's love. Okay, those whose love are actually sublunary, those who loves. Okay, as you know, you can I can give you example of one of the greatest romantic tragedy of William Shakespeare, that is Romeo and Juliet. So what happened in Romeo and Juliet? In Romeo and Juliet, actually in the beginning of the play, Romeo was in love with the cousin of Juliet. And when his friend asked him about her, he said that she is one of the thousands. But when in the party at the Juliet's house, he saw Juliet, then he murmured or uttered that Juliet is one of the millions. It means that his love changed. His love shifted from Juliet's cousin to Juliet. So the whose soul is sense cannot admit. Okay. Because such people who actually far, now Romeo was very far from the Juliet cousin, and therefore his love shifted, because he was now in close, he was in contact with the Juliet, so therefore his love shifted from her cousin to her. So those people whose soul is sense cannot admit absence, because it doth remove those things which eliminate it. And because of that kind of a false lovers, when they separate each other, their love also vanished. But here he said that he is a true lover, and therefore his love is true, and he will not actually going to deceive her. He is not going to forgive her. He is not going to forget her. So that is the thing. So guys, I think I have completed 8 lines of this poem here. 10 lines of this poem. And the remaining part of this poem we are going to see tomorrow. So up to it, thank you for watching, and don't forget to fill the attendance form, because your attendance is very important. And if you have any kind of queries, you can ask me anywhere. So thank you for watching.